gentlemen, if I could have your attention, please. Firstly, a really warm welcome back to Brighton. Most of you have obviously been here before. And it is a warm welcome because obviously we're blessed with some great sunshine today and warm temperatures, which makes the whole day a lot easier because it means we can spend some lots of time outside getting some fresh air as well, which is great. I think I have met pretty much everybody in this room, which is super, and if I haven't, I'm sorry. Obviously, my name is Richard Jones, and I'm lucky enough to be the head of this wonderful school. So today is familiarisation day. So it pretty much does what it says on the tin. Primarily, it is an opportunity for all the pupils who are joining us in September to get to know the campus, to meet some of the key members of staff here at the school, but most importantly, it's an opportunity for you, the pupils, to start to get to know each other on what is hopefully the start of a nice 5-year journey between you all. And obviously for the parents as well, it's an opportunity for you to spend some quality time here on site to get to know some of the key pastoral staff in particular. You're going to spend some time in houses. It's an opportunity to have... An opportunity to come and have a bit of a Q&A this afternoon with various different members of staff, but also for you to meet each other and start forming some connections as parents as well. So I'm sure you feel the same as certainly we do as a school, that the last few years it's been incredibly difficult for parents to actually meet with one another and almost have that social aspect, which is important as well. So having taken over as the head this year, the good news is that you guys will be my kind of first full cohort that I will take through, which is really exciting. So we will get to go on this journey together, and hopefully we can help each other out along the way. It is an exciting time for the school. The times we've been living in have been challenging, but now we can put all that behind us and we can look forward, and that is exciting. And my job as the head of Brighton is not to reinvent the wheel. You guys are all sat here because you've chosen this school because of what it does, because of the ethos of the school, because of the philosophy of the school, and I've got no interest in changing any of that. So Brighton will always put the pupils at the heart of what we do. That focus on the individual, the one-to-one tutoring, is the USP of the school, if you will, and we will enhance that and we'll make it better as well. We will continue to focus on independence. And again, our whole Brighton method, our academic approach, is about that independence. Lots of structure, but as and when they're ready, giving them the space in which to think creatively and unbounded thinking. 2 weeks ago, we held an education summit here, and I know there's a few people in the room here who were able to attend. We had over 250 different teachers from all over the country, and we had a stellar list of speakers, and this was one of the venues that we used. Poet laureate Simon Armitage was here, we have the author Michael Rosen was here, and the title of the summit was Putting Pupils at the Heart of a Changing World. For me, in order to do that, in order to put children at the heart of this changing world, we need to continue to focus on their health, on their happiness, and building productive pupils. And for this, we need to encourage them to ask questions as well as pass exams, and that's really crucial. Adolescence, we know, is a special time, but it's also a difficult time, okay? But with a careful mixture of guidance and also affording them the space to think things out for themselves, we hope to give them the strength that they require for adult life. So as we continue to look forward at the journey that we're hoping to go on as a school, I've talked about some of the key fundamentals that will always remain part of Brighton. But we're also talking about what are the key areas that we want to build as areas of excellence for the school. And there's four pillars that I've articulated and spoken about. One of those is our creative and performing arts. We have a strong reputation in this area, and it's something that we will continue to build. Our sport. We are blessed with some of the best facilities in the country. Again, we want our provision and our outcomes to match the level of facilities that we have. And then two sort of slightly newer areas that we're focusing on as well, talking about the changing world in which we operate. One is a focus on the digital world. And I know digital scares people, but we've got to embrace it, okay? We've got to educate our pupils around it. We've got to teach them how to learn and use it appropriately. So making sure that when they leave here, they are digitally literate, OK? Okay, really important to what we do. And finally, entrepreneurship and innovation as a central strand that will run through their time here. We do not know what jobs we are preparing your children for. We've got no idea, honestly speaking, in 5, 6, 7, 8 years what the market's going to look like. But if we can build that culture of creative thinking, unbounded thinking, the entrepreneurship, the innovation, it will put them and stand them in good stead when they leave here. Back to today, I just want to read out a little snippet, which was a review of the school published by Talk Education, which is an education magazine. They came to visit us recently. And this is just a little bit of what they said about Bryanston from what they picked up when they were here. Laid back and liberal have long been the buzzwords for Bryanston. But for those in the know, it's anything but. Rippling with energy, talent and individualism, this school may feel much more innovative and progressive than some. And yes, creativity is still at the heart of everything it does. But we rarely come across anywhere with the same level of one-to-one attention and sky-high standards too. Quirky works here, because there's no pressure to fit into a mould. The Bryanston method not only serves to get pupils through their exams, but it sets them up for a lifetime of making things happen for themselves, which is invaluable in today's fast-paced world. Busy, buzzy, and a place where all talents are celebrated. That, for me, I think reflects and sums up the school that I see on a day-to-day basis and the school that I love. And it's my job and the job of all the teachers here to make sure that we continue with that. So going back to today, we've obviously got a collection of individuals in front of us. Hopefully it's the start of you guys starting to form friendships and starting to form a community that, like I say, will last over the journey that you are on here. Kindness is a word that will have been no doubt drilled into you at prep school, and you'll continue to hear it here. Kindness is key. And today, there'll be some of you sat here who have our older siblings at the school who will feel completely comfortable and relaxed about today. There'll be others who are not as comfortable but have got a few friends with them from prep school, and therefore that's a bit of a crutch. And there'll be others who may not even have been here before. Okay? So my ask of you, the pupils, today is that you are perceptive, that you keep an eye out, that you look out for people, and that you ask lots of questions about each other. Challenge yourself to speak to different people who you have never, ever met before, because I promise you, over the course of the next few years, you're going to get to know them well, and I hope they will become lifelong friends. In a second, I'm going to hand over to Darren, who's going to talk about just some of the logistics for the rest of the day. But I'm going to leave you with a song in a minute, and a few images will come up here. As I've said, Bryanston is a unique school. It does things a bit differently, and it has a personality and a vibrance to it that I haven't seen at any other school that I've been part of. And we've tried to put that down into words with something called the Bryanston Promise. And it's a promise to the pupils, to the parents, to the old Bryanstonians, to the staff. Talks about what we aim to do at Bryanston. And I think it's a real powerful document, a powerful promise. And on your way out, everybody will get one of those and you can take it away and read it. But in true Bryanston style, one of our OBs, who only left last year, read this promise. And he, pretty much in a couple of hours in the afternoon, he wrote a song based on the promise and based on what he felt his experience of Bryanston was and what the school meant to him. And I need to read it, I'm in fast. So I'm going to play that. Have a listen to it, just listen to the words. And like I say, this has come from a Bryanston pupil who left last year. And then on the back of that, we'll hear a bit about the logistics. And I will be around, and please do come and grab me and ask any questions. But I'm really, really excited about the journey that we are all about to go on together. And I can't wait to get to know this cohort of pupils over the next few years.
When we run outside, we quote in movie lines. And when we sing, we have the future in our eyes. It was an early spring when the sun came rolling in, and we knew that we were nothing like the rest. 'Cause the world's a game, but we're ready to take the test. be a spark to the flame, moving mountains and nothing less. Mountains and nothing less. We may not always be what we thought we'd see when we look into the mirror of ourselves. Accepting who we are, even when it's hard, it's a journey of who we're meant to be. It's a chance to let go, feel the rhythm and time to grow. It's not only what you know, it's the music within your soul. Oh, it's the music within your soul. We explore it all. Taking every opportunity. This is my voice, this is my sound, these are my words when I sing it out loud. We have our goals, big and small, and teach us how to rise when we fall, and be our guide through the thick of it all. Learn to love your mind, this is a chance to find all the reasons why we're even here at all. We philosophize, discover, theorize, creating visions of what we want to see. And it all comes down to the change we want to be. And it all comes down to the ways we are unique. We explore it all, both old and new. We're looking for every point of view. We take our minds, we set them free. We're taking every opportunity. This is my voice, this is my sound. These are my words when I sing it out. Small, teach us how to rise when we fall, and be our guide through the thick of it all. When we ran outside, we quoted movie lines, and when we sing, we have the future in our eyes.